Hello, and welcome to another episode of Minecraft, and today I'm going to be, making, I just want to see how far this thing goes. I'm going to be making little cool sculptures or patterns and stuff. But I'm only gonna, like, select a certain thing to, like, use. So let's do, as you might can tell, this is, the things I used in my new, Minecraft new thing. So, yeah, I'm using the same stuff as that sculpture. I keep wanting to say sculpture, but it's not a sculpture. It's just a cool thing. Kind of like a sculpture, but anyway, not a sculpture. No. What happened there? Why did that go, like, above? So it happened again. Why did that happen? How and why? Like, that's such a glitch. And then, No! Why? Ooh, a change of plans. Instead, because that was just too frustrating and stuff, I'm gonna be playing with this village. Also with snow golems and iron golems and monsters. By the way, this was actually my plan the whole time, so yeah. I know it was kind of weird to have a sudden change, but that was just, like, I was about to just, like, just something. That was irritating me so much. Where are pumpkins? Are pumpkins in blocks? I would imagine they are, right? Oh, yeah, there they are. An iron block. Let's get an iron block. Oh, also, let's see. Where is it? Here it is. I'm not gonna be using that stuff anymore. I might use that, but not that. Oh wow, that really did clear up a lot of the area, didn't it? So, I'm gonna make a snow golem army. Little snow golem troops all over the place. Yeah. And then set them for free. And then I'm gonna get a simple mob like just zombies. Now I know you're like, well, why are they getting hurt? It's not the zombie, but they're actually hitting each other with snowballs, which doesn't actually matter because snowballs do zero damage. So, look. If I have a ton of villagers, I mean, not villagers, zombies here. Come on, snowballs, protect that villager. So, as you can see, the troops do die out eventually. Like, they do slowly die, as you can see. All of the remains of the guys with the snowballs. Now, I know you're like, wait, if it does no damage, why did it hurt the zombie? Well, snowballs do no damage whenever thrown by a player. They also do no damage to snow golems. So, like, no matter how many times he hits another snow golem, it won't die. Like, here's an example. If I have a spot here. With a zombie, then how did that happen? Here, why? With a snow golem, so no. Nope. See, look, it keeps hitting that guy, but, like, he's not dying. And remember, these guys only have two hearts. Seriously, look. Of course, I was hitting with a snow block, but they only have two hearts. Or at least as far as I know. I'm pretty sure they do, but you know, like, they're really weak. See, pardon me. If I put a snow golem there, a zombie there. Oh, well, that was a little unfair, wasn't it? Huh. Let me just get a netherite sword just in case, you know, stuff gets out of hand. For whatever reason, like, I don't know why in the world that would happen. Definitely won't be my fault by spawning 10,000 zombies at the end and 10,000 snow golems at the end. Definitely won't be my fault. See, he only has two hearts. Zombie took him out in two hits. So, yeah. Oh, by the way, zombie, you might want to like so yeah, I know, I set you free. You're happy, right? Yeah, well. Oh, snow. You might want to run now, dude. 'Cause old Frankie is coming for you. So, now we have iron golems. Now, you can see he's just getting killed, right? Well, the zombies caught. Well, look at that. I'm just keep on healing him with the iron ingots. Or I can, at least. So I'm going to make a army of iron golems and a ar and a army of zombies, and I'm gonna see which one wins. So there will be and by army I mean like one troop. So like five. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then let's just the snow. I hate the snow whenever it's just always getting in the way of making snow golems. I mean, not snow golems. You know, these guys. Well, they did that pretty easily, but what if I do this? Looks like they're kind of getting crumbled, aren't they? A little bit. Oh, first loss for the Iron Golems. And any more losses? Oh, well, some strays got involved, so that's a little unfair. Actually, I guess it is kind of fair. Like, this is what they're dealing with out in the real world, so. Other than the giant hordes of zombies, that they're not dealing with. So, what if I just do this? And there are four iron golems. And oh, second loss for the iron golems. Oh, third. Right, so far. It's been two troops of zombies. Oh. So, another loss for the Iron Golems. Is it gonna be three troops or four troops to take out five Iron Golems? Oh, three troops of zombies took out an Iron Golem. All right. Well then, five iron golems was pretty good, but I think we need more. No, not trying to destroy that. Trying to destroy all the snow before I place in the blocks. Hold on. So let's spawn in one troop of zombies. All right, troop of zombies, and then come on, move around. Iron golems. Am I gonna have to seriously break these blocks? All right. Going iron golem. So, looks like iron golems have had no losses. They kind of split up a lot, though. Well, let's see what happens if I add Oh, I don't know, like raids instead. Yeah. That makes sense because they're gonna be dealing with raids a lot, you know? So. Let's get out some raid guys. Ravagers? Vindicator? Where's the witches? Evoker? So let me try to find W. It'll be down here. Ah, witch. I don't need to get out vexes because, you know, those just spawn naturally. So let's just get a little raid going. And then some evokers. And then witches. The snow again. Alright, let's see how this small tree does. Alright, first loss for the Iron Golems. And second loss for the Iron Golems, third loss for the Iron Golems. Alright. Now let's just spawn a ton of these guys. Let's spawn a small troop. Just a tiny little troop. Oh, they're shooting at the Vexes, so the snow golems are good for the Vexes, but they don't go after anything else. It seems like. Yeah, they're just ignoring the witches and stuff. Well, what if I put a medium or a little bit of a bigger troop. Right, so bigger troop. Also, by the way, I did not know this, but you can actually make a snow golem by doing this. See? Really cool, huh? So, that huge army has actually taken care of the raid pretty well. Oh. Looks like they attacked a creeper. Snow golems actually do that. Well, let's see how they handle it if I spawn, like, oh, just a couple ravagers. That's just a small amount of ravagers. Oh, wow. Ooh. Oh, gosh. I think I did spawn a couple too many ravagers. Anyway, that. I need to get this. I see an igloo, and I like igloos. Oh my gosh, I just realized something. Igloos aren't igloos anymore. Like, the best way to open up an igloo is to just place snow golems just all over the place. It destroys every bit. Oh wow. Is this one with a carp with aha, it is. You know what, actually? Snowgolem friends, why don't you follow me down? Alright, here's the thing. Let's break that. Let's go in here, get to the splash potion of weakness. Get the golden apple. Get the emerald. Weakness on him, then feed him the golden apple. I'm gonna get a zombie villager out. Anyway, that is gonna be the end of the episode. Bye!